Hello everyone, I'm Something Wicked and welcome to the Wicked Workshop. I've got a quick video for you today. This one is just going to be a quick little tip on Map Creator, something that I picked up in the Tabs Workshop Center from a user named Kejin and 055, no, instead of jacking up his name, I'm just going to go right to it, okay? 055F00 and Kejin, Kejin's the one who actually referred me to it, but it's pretty simple. We're going to be taking objects that you use in Map Creator, and you're going to use the game to manipulate objects. Now, this is the way that he does it: places a slanted object, and then he grabs it. And anytime that you place an object, you'll notice that when you kind of move it on any kind of a slope, it will kind of roll forward, or you know, kind of angle. And that's what we're going to be using. I found a little exploit to be able to manipulate that and to be able to get consistent results, and a few other little tricks, or you know, tips and tricks that I've picked up. But basically, so once you get it to roll forward, you're going to select it, you're going to click on it, and then let it roll, and then place it, and then you're going to pick it up again in the same spot, and the game will naturally roll it forward again, and then you deselect it, and then you reselect it, and then deselect it, reselect it, deselect it, and you keep on doing that until you get to your desired angle. And he says that the note here is that you want to do it one more than what you intend on it to be, because when you grab it again, the game will, you know, default it back one angle. So like I said, I went through that and looked at everything, and I've come up with a way that I think is really simple, and it works pretty well for me, and I'm going to show it to you guys right now. So we're in game right now. What I've done is just basically loaded up one of my base winter maps that I'm going to start using, and you'll notice that I'm in the terrain manipulation menu, and I've got the longest, narrowest piece. If you look at it, it's as smooth as it can possibly be, okay? And it's as small as it can possibly be, okay? Leaving the angle as a right angle, not making any adjustments to that. So the reason why I've made this little complex is I've made it at right angles that are all perpendicular to the start line, to what the game's baseline is. And I've found, as you can see, my lines are all pretty crisp and clear when it comes through here, so that everything that I do, I try to base it off of right angles. And if you look down at my screen, you can see where the screen kind of goes, and you just move it so that it's about even colored bar sizes. So I'm going to go with that. And then all I'm going to do is make one single, and I'm going to drag it straight down so that it's as straight as I can possibly make it. Okay. So there's that. That's the start of it. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select my little block on my, I think it's under architecture. Yeah, this little L-shaped block right here. Okay. I'm going to rotate it so that it's parallel with this piece. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. I think 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is what I was using. Okay. And as you notice, as I move it up and down, it kind of rolls forward and back. And that is what we want to use to our advantage. And then once it does that last roll is where I'm going to place it. I'm going to actually bring it over here a little bit. So once it does that last final roll, so that's about as far as it'll go. So I'm going to place it right about there. Okay. Now I'm going to hit 2 on my keyboard so that it brings up my my separate menu, and I want to use that line menu, or that line tool, and I'll grab 4 or 5 of them. But the key is there, as I'm lining them up, I want them to follow the exact same roll. So I'm going to bring it down just until it does that final roll on that last one, and there it is. It's straight. Well, seems straight enough. You know, I'm going to get rid of that one, because these ones are all pretty good. So that's basically what I want. So I've already used the game's roll mechanic and then made 4 of them so that each one of them has the exact same roll, so that that amount of space, no matter basically wherever I put my next object, that amount of space will manipulate a roll even more. See how it naturally rolls a little bit? Now, if I want to keep that object, I'll use a different object. For now, let's just use a tree, a regular log. Okay, I'm going to rotate it over so that it's perpendicular to my object. Okay, and as you can see, it's already doing that roll. Okay, so once it does its final roll, I'm going to click. Okay. I'm going to right click so that I can just select that one object again. I'm going to grab it again and see how it rolled one more time. Okay. Click, unclick it, click, unclick. So select, deselect, just like that, guys. And it's going to roll on that same plane, as you can see. So that's probably the last one that I want to do if I want it to stand up straight. So I'm going to grab it again. Nope, I want to keep on going. Okay. Let's do another one. Okay. Until, and there it is. It's almost vertical. I might do one more. No, that's pretty well vertical. Nope, one more. Okay, and there it is. Okay, well, it's got a little bit of a forward lean. But that's pretty vertical. And of course, you can drag it up and down. You can manipulate it. But now since I'm doing all of my adjustments on 90 degree angles, you notice that I rotated it completely 90 degrees so it would be perpendicular to this object. Everything's going to kind of have that different lean. Now watch when I grab, I used a set of stairs before that was really cool. And I stood it basically, so we're going to flip it so that it's perpendicular to it. Now watch this, guys. Watch when I grab this. Ready? Drag it down so that it rolls to its forwardmost point. Okay. And then I'm going to just keep on doing that. And it's going to walk that thing forward. How awesome is that? Okay. And that gives you different applications if you want to, say, for example, throw it on the wall. Or I had one where I think if I use it on this side, I can basically get it so that it's flat and it's almost like a platform. Okay, let's try that. But all different kinds of things that you can do with that. If I want to try to make some barbed wire, like Kejin showed me just recently. Actually, no, it's going to be down here. The little fence deal. There it is. Okay. So that it's parallel or perpendicular. And then there was my angle right there. So I'm going to grab it again. And it's just walking it straight over, guys. Look at that. Just leaning it straight over, and then I can throw that down like that. If I want to do the other side, I just repeat the same process. My apologies, I can think and breathe into the microphone. Six. Okay, and then as soon as I get that forward roll, that's where I'm going to place it. Okay, hit two to get my line grabber thingy. Okay, and then I'm going to grab just four of them or so, and then once they're straight and all four of them have that last roll. You know what? Actually, I'll just keep it with. I like that one better. So I'm just going to grab this one. Okay. There we go. And like I said, you can use about anything. If I wanted to make a wall out of this, look at that. Okay, one more time. You just have to be careful that you do it on the right angle so that you don't get like a like a turn like that. See, so there it is. And now I've got a vertical wall that I can place. That's about it, guys. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. I'm going to keep on trying to bring you out. Yeah, see, there you go. That's kind of cool. All different kinds of things that you can do with it. So that's all I got for you, guys. Something wicked out.